breakfast television provided in part by Tim's Omelette Bites. Back in two delicious flavors, bacon and cheese, and spinach and egg white.
Hey, I just met you.
Your phones. You're not having issues with this at all.
We're doing an experiment, Devo.
Well, I'm fine. How you doing, Mary?
I'm fine.
Okay, no, so those are like jonesing right now.
Meredith's phone and my phone, in honor of the ongoing smartphone discussion that is happening specifically in the Toronto District School Board, Meredith and I, as of 6:59 Eastern this morning, have put our phones in the bowl of destiny, which we now have a 24/7 cam on. If you want to stream this on YouTube, you can't. It's not on YouTube. But that is the bowl of destiny. How many viewers on YouTube would this get right now?
Well, hello to the YouTube community.
Love the YouTube
streaming
community.
Us right now.
Just straight that's the only shot with comments.
That's the shot with comments.
And then sometimes
someone's
there's
hands
like a random hand.
Someone's like, no.
Yeah. All right, I'm fine.
Okay,
we're great.
Good. Yeah, it's just the show.
We're doing great. You know what else will give me a similar reaction? The coming U.S. presidential election.
Oh boy, here we go.
So look, there's a lot of polls going on right now, and the Republicans are getting ready for Tuesday, which is New Hampshire, the second state in the primaries. Nikki Haley actually sounds like has a shot Tuesday. Trump may not romp. But big picture, Angus Reid decided to ask a few very important questions. And apparently a lot of Americans are not going to accept this election result, whatever happens. One in three Americans, I'm going to repeat that, one in three Americans will accept the 2024 results regardless of who wins. That means there's a lot who will not. One in two will accept results if their candidate wins. Well, that makes sense. That's setting up democracy for a good spot. The rest would doubt the results no matter who wins it. There's a lot of places to take this. Like, let's focus on the states first and then bring it closer to home for us, because we're not that far away from our own election coming up in 2025, in theory, to either re-elect a prime minister or elect a new prime minister. But Meredith, this is set. My fear the whole time here hasn't been Trump. It hasn't been Biden. It's been the system. And I am beyond concerned at what is going to happen here, regardless of the result. If it's close, heaven help us, considering the institutions that have been chipped away at month over month over month over the past, now we're going on 10 years. And I think the results of that you are seeing in this poll, and I don't know how you unwind that clock.
No, I don't know either. I mean, it just represents a complete erosion in the faith in that sort of democratic system that they have set up. And that type of thing breeds apathy, it breeds ignorance, it breeds misinformation. And the results of that, come November, are going to be, they're going to be quite scary, kind of almost either way at this point. It's almost a lose-lose. And our proximity to that situation as Canadians is, we got to stay involved and informed.
Yeah, when the neighbors are in a moment here, and we've all had moments where our neighbor's been in one, however you define that, you get a little nervous regardless what it is, because you're there. How nervous are you?
It's scary.
Yeah.
I go there quite a bit for what we do. And to think, I'm going to take my ball and go home. Like, that's what it is. Like, I am angry if my person doesn't win. I don't believe anything. The system is broken unless you agree with me. So the divisiveness that's continuing in the United States is scary to me. And I don't know where that path takes us. It takes us down a very dangerous road.
I think we saw a bit of that path,
did we not? That's kind of what I'm alluding to, and I don't, you know what I mean?
That's all I'm thinking about right now.
Like, I'm scared for what can possibly happen in the future in that country within it.
Yeah.
And now you're imploding.
So do you anticipate, final question, because we're not going to be far removed from one as well, does whatever happens in the states impact the next Canadian election for prime minister and the 300 some on MPs that are going to the House of Commons. Like, do you think we get affected to that point? Because that's where people say, well, democracy's under attack. Democracy's only under real attack when no one trusts it. Mm-hmm. That's the issue here. Mm-hmm. Not January 6th, people are in prison all over the place. They weren't going to get away with that. Mm-hmm. Mike Pence certified. It happened. It was scary as heck. Mm-hmm. It happened, though. When people just don't trust it, like, we're in January, and people are like, we'll see how it plays out. Like, I don't think that's going to happen here. Am I naive? I don't think that's going to be a Canadian symptom.
No, but there are political cycles that we see over time.
Yes.
And, you know, we had a Barack era, and then we led back to a Trump. It's like it swings one way, it kind of swings the other. And we're a cycle behind. So read through that statement as well.
I see what you're saying.
You know, we're a cycle behind.
I don't think we get it to the extent, the amount. I think you will have a few that will kind of have that mentality and be similar to that. But I don't think as a majority you see that in this country, and I hope. I mean, maybe that's wishful thinking, but that's kind of where I'm at with it.
It's hopeful thinking.
Yeah.
I'm all for hopeful. I'm one of the most pessimistic people to have ever been on television in this country. But even myself in this moment, I'm horrified at numbers like this. Mm-hmm. Horrified, because that's all we got. Then what is it? Who are our neighbors? Who are we? Like, this is it. This is order. This is some semblance of, okay, this is how we're going to do things. Majority will at some point rule. And if that's not the case, all right, whoever's got the biggest gun wins then. And that's a place no one wants to be. But I am hopeful thinking on that.
Yeah.
I don't think it's wishful thinking. I'm hopeful thinking.
And our political systems are one of the biggest differentiators between Canada and America.
Yes.
It's effect, unique. Yes. But we do hold strong to who we are politically,
yes.
Which is one of our greatest differences.
Agreed. To be continued. To be continued after the break. Faiza's got news. Also coming up on this Friday edition. It's Friday on Breakfast Television. If you've got questions about how to get healthy in the new year, we got you covered. Shout out Bryce Wild. Take a walk on the wild side with Bryce. Joining us next. I don't miss my phone at all. You're watching VT.